You know, talking about hard moments and, you know, getting yourself to the start line, what about Jim Howley? He's a guy that contracted AIDS. He had a T-cell count of 3, I believe.
Right.
That was one of the most inspirational moments for me, too.
What was amazing is Jim Howley actually came up to me at the Wildflower Triathlon and told me he was going to try to do the Ironman Triathlon. His T-cell count was 3. His doctor told him that if he tried to do something like the Ironman, that because he had AIDS, that the disease would eat whatever muscle mass he had, and he'd die. His doctor called me and said, if this guy tries to do the Ironman, he will die. Jimmy proved them wrong. Let's go to the video and check out the Jim Howley story.
The doctor said to me, I have bad news and I have worse news. The bad news is you have AIDS. The worst news is your T-cell count is below 200, and that meant I had about 16 months to live at that point. Everyone that I know that's been diagnosed as long as me, or even after me, is gone. I know tomorrow I may not be here. We didn't think that there was any hope whatsoever. I believe HIV and so many other diseases are diseases of disempowerment. Exercise empowers people, and I believe it does that by changing our attitudes. And when we change our attitudes, we have courage, and when we have courage, we have the empowerment. And I think exercise can give everybody the power to say no to whatever it is they don't want in their lives. Last year at this time, I had 3 T-cells, which basically means I have no immune system. The latest count was 260 T-cells. That was unheard of. That was not supposed to happen. When they look at my blood for the virus, it's been undetectable for 13 months. They can't find the virus in the blood. That doesn't mean it's not there. But see, to me, now all of a sudden, I have a future. With 3 T-cells, I didn't.
Essentially, at this point in time, even though Jim has a history of all these AIDS-defining conditions, his immune system has strengthened to the point where you could argue whether or not he has AIDS.
I think I'm here now to help other people realize what I realized without having to face death like I had to. Every triathlon proves to me that I'm probably going to be here a little bit longer, right? Because I have no role models. Everyone that I know that's been diagnosed as long as me or even after me is gone. So I give myself my own role modeling. I finish a race, and if I can finish the Ironman, that gives me probably at least another couple months in my mind.
Is this guy nuts? No, he's somebody who really wants to pursue a dream, and this has been his dream. And this, is, I think, is what is keeping him alive.
I have to start thinking about the future. You know, what if I get better? You know, what if the HIV goes away? You know, I better start having plans for the future. But last year, I didn't even think I'd make it to this day.
Several years ago, Jim made out his will. His last wish? To have his ashes scattered over this Ironman course. But now, armed with new drugs to fight AIDS, Jim Howley has a healthy respect for life.
Jim Howley, like so many others, changed perceptions of what someone can accomplish and what the human body can do, and he did it through the Ironman.
Yeah, he certainly did, and today Jim Howley is up and going and doing very well.
He works for Abbott Laboratory, and he's involved with, obviously, the AIDS movement. And Jim Howley is one of the great success stories of Ironman.